morning. Thank you for your invitation. It's a great honor for me. I was invited from APSR to speak in Vietnam, and I directly approve it because I know it been a great development in Vietnam and also in health development. My first speech is about lung cancer diagnosis from interventional pulmonology perspective. This is my university, Erlangga University in Indonesia, and this is our hospital, Dr. Sutomo Hospital and Erlangga University Hospital. Please, if you have time, visit to our city. And I hope we can continue this collaboration in the next time. This is my outline presentation. For introduction, lung cancer is the leading cause of cancer death worldwide. And as we see, NSCLC accounts for the majority, approximately 85% of lung cancer, with the remainder as mostly small cell lung cancer. Interventional pulmonology has a pivotal role in multidisciplinary lung cancer care with significant impact on quality of care. This is our goal from interventional pulmonology. First, to clinical extent and stage of the disease, and we can choose the optimal target site and modality for the tissue biopsy, and we can choose the specific histological subtype, and we can know the comorbidities, complication, and paraneoplastic syndrome. And the last one is we can discuss with the patient values and preference. Diagnosis of lung cancer should not be made without definitive pathology, as we know, whether involves selecting a biopsy site and obtaining an adequate sample for microscopic examination. Additional consideration is we have to obtain a large enough sample for immunohistochemical and genetic analysis, because as we know, the genetic analysis and immunohistochemical is the future treatment of the lung cancer. This is our main discussion in this topic. For the conventional bronchoscopy, flexible bronchoscopy is a procedure that visualizes the lumen and mucosa of the trachea, proximal airways, and segmental airways to the third generation of branching. We know as a standard white light bronchoscopy. Conventional flexible bronchoscopy we can achieve with the forceps biopsy, brushing, or washing, or bronchoalveolar lavage. Is best utilized for assessing large central lesion and those with suspected airway involvement. We can achieve the target in the enlarged subcranial, paratracheal, and hilar nodes. Though flexible bronchoscopy is useful for visible endobronchial and central lesion with overall sensitivity of 88%, the diagnostic yield for peripheral lesion decreased significantly, with a sensitivity of 34% for nodules less than 2% and 63% for nodules more than 2 centimeters respectively. And then how to increase the yield? We have to make additional tools with ultrasound. As we know, the endobronchial ultrasound has emerged as the most common modality used for diagnosis and staging of suspected non-small cell lung cancer. It is increasing in diagnostic accuracy. Commonly used, the linear Abbott bronchoscope is a hybrid scope that has an ultrasound probe built at the distal end. It allows the airways to be visualized similar to a standard bronchoscope, and additionally allows the structure surrounding the airways to be visualized. There are two types of EBAS, as we know, convex probe EBAS, CP EBAS, or as we know, EBAS transbronchial needle aspiration, EBAS TPNA, and the radial probe EBAS, or EBAS guide sheath for the peripheral lesion. This is the indication for the using of the EBAS. Most of them are for bronchial cancer and lymph node staging. This is the advantage of the using IBAS. You can see in the slide, and this is the advantage of the IBAS. For example, we cannot image or sampling subaortic on paraesophageal lymph node. Technically, it's a little bit difficult to perform, not widely available, and only small needles can be used for IBAS-CPNA. But in the recent journal, if we compare bigger needle or small needle for performing the genetic analysis with a good technique and the good preparation is similar, the result. And this is the lymph node we can reach in the IBAS. This is the map. The yellow sign, we can achieve it with the IBAS-CPNA and mediastinoscopy. And the blue sign, we cannot reach with the IBAS-CPNA. So we have to consult with our colleagues from the internal medicine to perform the AUS. Esophageal ultrasound, fine needle aspiration. Ritual et al. Perform the sensitivity and specificity IBAS-CPNA is 85% and 100%. With the combination of IBAS and with AUS, we have the better access and increasing the sensitivity of 93% and negative predictive value of 97%. This is the map of the lymph node. We have to install it in our brain, yeah. So we can choose the sampling at the proper location. This is the examples of the ultrasound imaging for the IBAS. You can see in the left upper is the round shape, and the left right upper is the heterogeneous echogenicity, and the lower left is a distinct margin. You can see the white margin, and the last one is the coagulation of the necrosis sign. We can see in the white arrow. This is the factor influencing the diagnostic yield of transbronchial needle aspiration. For example, the presence of lymph node enlargement, the type of needle employed, the site of the tumor and lymph node location, lymph node size. Yeah, you can see in this slide. Continue, which is IBAS-CPNA for the peripheral lesion. This is the tools that we can use for the detecting in peripheral nodules. Yeah, the basic is already quite the same for using the ultrasound in the transthoracic site. Yeah, you can see the hypoechoic signs. Yeah, and this is the procedure of the IBAS guide sheets. Number one is the probe. It is advanced until it reaches a point where the operator feels resistant, heart resistance, and is then pulled back for scanning. Number two, once the location of the lesion has been identified precisely using IBAS, the probe is withdrawn, leaving the guide sheets in its place. And the last is biopsy forceps or a bronchial brush is introduced into the sheath, so we can make a good tissue sampling. This is also the ultrasound sign. A and B is show the within the lesion, and the C and D is so adjacent to the lesion. The best result is A and B within the lesion. This a picture shows the help of the fluoroscopic imaging to make a decision whether we can take the sampling or not. Again, this is a classification of peripheral pulmonary lesion by IBAS. Type 1, A and B is homogeneous pattern. Type 2 is hyperechoic dots and linear arch pattern. Type 3 is heterogeneous pattern. We continue with the imaging, advanced imaging in bronchoscopy. Yeah, autofluorescent bronchoscopy, narrow beam imaging, high magnification bronchoscopy, and optical coherence tomography. This is the autofluorescence bronchoscopy. AFB is one method of identifying pre-malignant or malignant lesion that not seen with standard white light bronchoscopy. It also helps us to detect cancerous tumors in the early stages. Under fluorescence, health issues appear green and abnormal issues appear reddish brown. Once abnormal tissue are identified, small sample of the tissue for we can take for further analysis. This is a sample of the autofluorescence that shows maybe it the cancerous cancer area, so we can decide to take the sampling in here. This is one journal that compared the autofluorescence imaging compared with the white light bronchoscopy for detection of lung cancer. Here we can see the sensitivity is higher than white light bronchoscopy. We continue to the narrow beam imaging. We can use this imaging still to make the precision location of the tumor in the mucosa. Yeah, for example, like this. Yeah. Sorry, and the low right side is the like the black dot area. Then we can decide to perform the biopsy in here. This is also the picture of the narrow beam imaging that shows the black area that we can. We can decide to take the samples. We continue that the high magnification bronchoscopy is a white light bronchoscopy system that provides up to 110 times the magnification of the bronchial mucosal vasculature. We can see the increased vessel density that can be associated with the premalignant or malignant change. Yeah, this. In the left side, we can see the vasculature is more prominent with the scanning of the high magnification video bronchoscopy. Sorry. We continue to the optical coherence tomography. Yeah, used to of the light wave in a similar manner the, to that of ultrasound. Yeah, it produces much more detailed image and allows the first 2 to 3 millimeters of the bronchial walls to be visualized. Just for example, the use of optical coherence, yeah. But still, we can criticize it, yeah. That optical coherence still cannot replace the histology of the diagnosis of lung cancer carcinoma. And the last one is navigation guided transbronchial biopsy. We can divide it into two group. Yeah. Yes. The virtual bronchoscopy is a non-invasive form of bronchoscopy. It is not an endoscopic procedure, but rather an imaging modality. Unlike flexible and rigid bronchoscopy, it cannot be used to acquire sample. The first is a virtual navigation bronchoscopy, or we can call VNB. It's like a GPS, yeah, to provide a mapping for guiding us into the direct location of the tumor. We use ultrasound bronchoscope, inserted and advanced through the airways, following the virtual guidance by matching the airway scenes on 3D with the real image obtained through the ultrasound bronchoscopy. This is the imaging of the virtual navigation of the bronchoscopy, like precisely like a GPS, yeah? Turn right, turn down, left, right, up and down. And continue with the electromagnetic navigation bronchoscopy, ENB. We use a special catheter with a sensor probe that is inserted through the working channel of a regular flexible bronchoscopy. The probe is then steered through the distal airways beyond the third generation of airways guided by an electromagnetic guidance system that is external to the patient. This is the electronavigation of the bronchoscopy. It's a little bit the same for the mapping or the GPS, how to reach the proper location of the tumor. This is a take-home message. We have a many way to reach a proper tissue sampling according to the location, patient's condition, facility, and team experience. We can decide to use regular bronchoscopy or with the helping of the ultrasound, ABAS, TPNA, and CAT-Sheets. Advanced imaging, for example, autofluorescent bronchoscopy, narrow beam imaging, high magnification bronchoscopy, and optical coherence tomography, and virtual bronchoscopy, VNB or ENB. But still, the tissue is the issue. Thank you very much.